Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Today our topic is the relation between the inverse hyperbolic function and logarithmic function. Let y is equal to sine hyperbolic inverse of x. To convert the inverse hyperbolic function to into the hyperbolic function, therefore sine hyperbolic of y is equal to x. In this case, x is an independent variable and y is a dependent variable. By definition, sine hyperbolic of y is equal to e raised to the power y minus e raised to the power minus y divided by 2 is equal to x. Rearrange this equation, we have e raised to the power y minus e raised to the power minus y is equal to 2x. Rearrange the equation. We have e raised to power y minus 1 divided by e raised to power y is equal to 2x. Taking the LCM and after the rearrangement, we have e raised to power y minus 1 is equal to 2x e raised to the power y. Now, rearrange this equation. We have e raised to power 2y minus 2x e raised to the power y minus 1 is equal to 0. Now this equation is a quadratic equation in e raised to the power y. To solve the value of e raised to the power y, we have to calculate the value of x first. We have to solve this quadratic equation to solve this step by, for e raised to the power y by quadratic formula, and after the rearrangement we have to calculate e raised the value of y. Now, after the rearrangement, the equation is a quadratic equation in e raised to the y. Compare this equation with the general quadratic equation we have. Compare and apply the quadratic formula for the calculation of e raised to the power y. We have substitute the values of a, b, c from the given data. We have the value of b is minus 2x, minus 45 and minus 2, plus 2x, plus or minus b square, 4x square, plus 4 multiplied by a, 4 multiplied by a is equal to 4 multiplied by minus 1 is equal to plus 4 square root divided by 2 multiplied by a. The value of a is equal to 1, and after the rearrangement, we have e raised to the power y is equal to 2x plus or minus 2 square root of x square plus 1 is a whole divided by 2. After the simplification, 2 is common in these two terms and cancel 2 with 2. We have x plus or minus x square plus 1 square the root, and which is equal to e raised to the power y. Since e is the value of e is equal to 2.718 and y is positive, therefore e raised to the power y is always positive. It is not equal to 0 nor negative 0 because e is the exponential function, the base e is equal to plus 2.718 and y is a positive value, therefore e raised to the power y is always positive in this case. Therefore, according to this condition, the x plus square the root x plus 1 and the value of e raised to the power y is x minus square root x square plus 1. There are two values of e raised to the power y. According to the condition e raised to the power y is always positive, the value of e raised to the power y is strictly equal to x plus square root x square plus 1. It may be negative if the value of x is so large that x square plus 1, the value of x square plus 1 square root is greater than the value of x. In this case, this value will be negative. Therefore, we conclude that the value of e raised to the power y is always positive. The condition will be satisfied only when the value of e raised to the power y is equal to x plus square root x plus 1. For example, the value of x is in this case is equal to 3. Suppose x is equal to 3. Substitute the value of 3 in
the equation x minus square root x square plus 1. After the calculation, we have minus 0.1622. And according to the condition, it is for y is always positive. The condition is valid for x is equal to 3 and onward quantities and so on. Therefore, we conclude that e raised to the power y is equal to x plus square root x square plus 1 square the root. That is, the condition will be always satisfied when the operator between these two terms is plus. To calculate the value of y, taking the natural log on both sides, log natural log on e raised to y is equal to natural log on the right hand side. Applying the property of the natural log, y multiplied by natural log of is equal to natural log of x plus square root x square plus 1. The natural log of e is equal to 1. Y multiplied by 1 is equal to y is equal to natural log of x plus square root x square plus 1. And y is actually the equal to sine hyperbolic inverse of x, which is in turn which we can calculate in terms of the logarithmic function, which is equal to natural log of x plus square root x square plus 1, which is the relation between the inverse hyperbolic and the logarithmic function.